time I ever heard of anybody coming all the way out here in a taxi before.
Must have cost a fortune.
I reckon.
$7.50. I heard my father says this.
Oh. Too bad my daddy didn't know. He was in Charlottesville yesterday. Could have given you a ride up here for nothing.
That would have been nice. You are...
Oh, I'm sorry. John Boy Walton.
How do you do?
How do you do? This is my sister Mary Ellen, my brothers Jason and Ben.
Hey.
Hi.
Happy to make your acquaintance. My name is Paul. Paul Mann.
Are you figure to stay around here, Paul?
Figure to stay? I'm sorry, my English is not yet very good.
Well, what my brother means is, are you going to be staying? Will you stay here in Walton's Mountain for a while?
Excuse me? Why do you wish to know?
Well, no reason, just asking.
If you do not mind, we will be on our way. Come, Eva.
We will stay for a while, yeah.
Well, bye, Paul.
Pleased to have met you. Auf Wiedersehen.
Bye. Sure talk funny, don't they?
That's his daddy. He's not very friendly.
Mr. Gossie?
Hi, kids.
Who are those folks?
Where'd they come from?
Where are they going to live?
Well, their name is Mann, M-A-N-N, and it's Professor and Mrs.
Professor?
That's right, from Berlin University.
Berlin in Germany?
Right again.
What are they doing here in Walton's Mountain?
Well, Doc Harrison wrote me from Richmond last week and told me that some friends had arrived in the United States unexpectedly, and he loaned them his summer cottage.
Doc Harrison's cottage? Well, that's just a little ways from our house.
Yeah.
Germany, huh? You know, Miss Hunter, at school, says there's going to be a lot of trouble over there.
It's already started.
What started?
Well, it's not easy to say. We just get the information in bits and pieces over the radio and in the newspaper, but ever since that fella Hitler took over, there's been a lot of changes.
Yes, it is.
John Boy, do they speak English?
Yes, they do, with a German accent.
You see the funny box he was holding?
Mm-hmm.
I bet they're spies.
No. Oh, Jesus.
Spies? You reckon, Jim Bob?
Sure, they got a radio in that box for sending out coded messages.
I declare, you too. Elizabeth, eat your squash.
Tastes good if you call it squish.
What kind of people they seem to be, son?
Oh, they were real polite. Father was kind of formal.
The boy, was he young or old?
Well, I'll tell you about him. He must have been a couple of years younger than Jason, but there was something odd about him.
Odd? Now, what do you mean by odd?
Well, I'm going to tell you. When you look at him, when I looked at him anyway, at his eyes, I don't know, I got the feeling he was older than I am.
Probably just tired out from the journey.
No wonder. Tomorrow, first thing, I'm going to bake an applesauce cake and take it over to him.
I wouldn't go there if I were you, Mama.
Why not?
Suppose it's not a radio they got in that box. Maybe it's a bomb.
Bomb.
Where in the Lord's name does that child get those ideas?
I told him.
Elizabeth, eat your squish.
And you children start using your napkins. Check it. Have some greens down there now.
Beneath the surface of a Germany united by Adolf Hitler, the government's official persecution of Jews quietly continues. Marriages between Aryans and Jews are forbidden by law, and now no Jew may teach or hold public.